Confesso, confesso.
Bons, tudo bom?
I'm back from a break. The round has resumed, so we are going to now move to some other games because Salim is still thinking of his move. I had some look around, and okay, for example, I saw that one interesting game was played between Andrei Isatescu and Sahaj Grover. Andrei Isatescu is one of the potential rating favorites of the tournament, but he got some accident on the road yesterday. He lost at Sicilian, which we were busy with, and he needs to win today with white badly if he wants to get back in the tournament. He's playing Sahaj Grover. Sahaj is one of the best young Indian players, and of course he's here to learn and to improve. But of course he's hoping to make a surprise beating one of the more known and famous players. So the game started as Ruy Lopez, and here what is interesting is that in the recent years well, players have been experimenting with the black pieces to play, let's say, improved Kosciuszko variation, because Kosciuszko variation is move knight g7. Knight g7 is a variation which is called Kosciuszko variation. But it has some certain problems. Namely, the problems are related to the fact that, let's say, after some move like, let's say, knight c3, with a later b4 to follow, white is quite fast often. The other option is, of course, moves like c3, but okay, c3 is often countered with a move like b5. Black players recently started very much to incorporate moves a6, bishop a4, and then move knight g7. Well, the reason behind being that, for example, now a similar kind of plan would work less good, because, like, for example, since this would move a6, bishop a4 included, let's say knight c3. Let's suppose that I play some move like knight to g6 if I want to. Or, which was actually played in game with d6. Now we see the difference, because let's suppose that on my move knight c3 here, the black play move d6. Then white would obviously play move like d4. Then white would play move d4, and white would have a better game. Now in the game, after knight c3 d6 with moves a6 bishop a4 included. Well, d4 now would not be such a fantastic deal, because black would be able to play, let's say, move d5, bishop b3, knight takes d4, knight takes d4, e takes d4, queen takes d4, and now c5, and c4 trapping the white bishop on d3. This is more or less the reasoning behind moves a6 bishop a4 inclusion in a Nicosia. There has been a lot of work done on this particular subject. I have done it myself in a book, Ruy López Revisited, which I wrote in 2009, and the book was published beginning of 2010 by New Chess. And also recently a book came out by Russian Grandmaster Alexei Dreyev on this particular system. So here what White does, White plays move A3. This move does not look like an ambitious move, but the main idea behind this that this bishop does not get trapped. This is possibility A, and possibility B that after bishop goes, let's say, to b3, that black does not have option to play move knight a5 and to swap his knight for a white square bishop, which would be a good deal for black. So a3 is actually smarter than it looks. a3, bishop d7. And now we have move bishop b3, which is the reason why move a3 was played in the first place. Idea of white is quite obvious. Bishop is hitting square f7. Square f7 is a vulnerable square for black and difficult to defend. So black has to do something to stop white move knight g5, because white wants to jump knight g5 next move. Black has two ways of doing this. One way is of playing move, let's say, like knight to g6, covering square g5, but if knight g6, there are a few problems which may occur. One, for example, is that move h4 can be quite unpleasant move. Remove h4, white is renewing his knight g5 threat, and also threatening to continue his pawn advance with h5, disturbing black knight on g6. So black takes a more radical step to remove white knight g5 idea. He plays move h6 in order to remove this possibility once and for all. Black has indeed now prevented white from jumping with knight to g5, but on the other hand, he also did lose some time. So for white, if he is to try to gain an initiative in this game, it makes perfect sense to open a center. And this is what white does in this game. He plays move d4, trying to open the center and to take advantage of this temporary advantage in development, because white is trying to open center before black has developed his pieces. Because black king will be still in the middle, black has to develop his bishop on f8, and white is ready to castle, so d4. Well, this pawn. Well, black is not forced to take this pawn, but the most logical is to take it. So knight d4, knight d4, e d4, king d4. Now is the question how for black to develop. Of course, the move which is perhaps the most natural is move like knight. To c6, developing with the tempi. But the problem of move knight c6 is that after, let's say, Queen e3, bishop em e7. White has a possibility if he wants to have playing a move, let's say like knight e5, and taking black bishop pair, which would grant white some sort of advantage. The second option would be more aggressive move like, let's say, like king g3. Also, it would be unpleasant because then after bishop f6, white can choose again for a move knight e5 if he wants to, trying to pick on those bishops. Though then black would have knight e4, also attacking white bishop on b3, so perhaps the safest way to gain the advantage would be indeed to jump knight e5 in this position and to be ready to always take the bishop's pair. So black is choosing for interesting approach. Black is here playing move bishop e6. What does black want? Black wants actually to exchange white unpleasant piece, which is a bishop on b3. And by exchanging this bishop, he would take back with the pawn. And then when he takes back with the pawn, he would also cover square d5 against possible knight jumps of a white. And then after, let's say, move like castles, black would be able to play a move like knight c6 and then to continue his development. So being on a crossroads, what white decides to do, white finally jumps with his knight to d5. White is actually trying to keep black somehow suffocated, because black has to develop his bishop and to castle. Because look, black pawn structure is okay. Black is not having any weaknesses, but problem for black is how to make a castle, how to take care that his king goes to safety. Because the problem is, for example, in the case of move like knight d5, then something very simple can happen. Let's say even bishop d5 is a possibility, but let's say d5, bishop d7, and then something very simple, let's say castles. And threat is move rook e1 check, which is a terrible threat since pawn g7 is hanging. And some moves like queen f6 are not really an option, because if white doesn't find anything better, he can just damage the pawn structure and have a massive advantage. But also white can just play for initiative with a move, let's say like queen c4. So this is in general black problem, that white would like to open a file, open a route to black king, then castle very quickly and take advantage of the fact that pawn on g7 is hanging and the bishop on f8 is not developed. So let's see how is black planning to solve this problem. Black plays move, very unusual move. He plays move b5. Now black's idea in the position is to lock white bishop out. So to play next move, let's suppose that white would just develop with the castles. Then black would probably play move c5, hitting on a white queen with the tempi. And then when queen goes away, he would continue with the move c4, locking temporarily this bishop out. Once this bishop is locked out, the chances to complete the development would improve. White does not want to see this happen, and he wants to ensure that his bishop remains active, so white plays move c4. I think that for black it would not be easy to finish development here. Sahaj Grover is a player who analyzed a lot, and he's often using, actually most of the time using computer in his homework, in his opening preparation. And most definitely, he did analyze his position, and very likely Silicon Brain, which has offered him some solution, which I'm interested to see because I like white. Because white is having more space, he's having the advantage in development, and it is really not so clear how is black going to solve his problem of his king in the center without being forced to compromise his position. Let's see how it how is this game going to continue. So c6, kicking the knight out. Okay. But just trying to understand. Aha, maybe this is the reason behind b5, because if c6 immediately, then I also had option to place moves like knight to b6. If I wanted to, because moves like c5 would be always impossible due to check on a4, for example. This would be impossible due to check on a4. And then if knight c6, then rook is hanging, and the bishop d7, then if I don't find anything more clever, I can just take everything, and then bring the pawn up. So it could be that move b5 actually has double function, that it was aimed on it was aimed to plan c5 with c4 to follow in order to shut this bishop out, but also aimed to ensure that move like c6 becomes possible for black. Okay, now for white, move like knight b6 is impossible because it would be a terrible blunder, since I no longer have any check on a4, so move like c5 would happen and I would lose my piece on b6. So white plays move knight f4, but black position does not look to me healthy. I'm really curious what did Sahaj analyze, because his king is in the middle, pawn on d6 can be potentially targeted. I'm going to castle very quickly. Also, if white jumps with the knight to h5, this white knight on h5 would be a nightmare, because if you be hitting on g7 and you cannot hit him with g6 because of knight f6 check, so I don't know, we are going to find out. Maybe there is some really forced sequence of moves which ensures that black gets out okay. But this adventure can finish very badly for black. Let's see if we have any further moves. Yes, we have a further move. We have a move c5. Move c5 has been played. Okay. This is the checked up. This is the last move of this game. Yes, c5 is the last move. Hitting a queen. Okay. Moment. First of all, white has two principal options. Oh, maybe black wants to bring his knight to d4. Maybe this is his idea. Because I'm just now thinking that, okay, white, for example, white can take. This is what white can do if he wants to. Because black queen is hanging as well, so black is forced to take. And now white can, for example, decide to move his queen, threatening c takes b5 with bishop e6 to follow. So now the question is, how can black counter such a threat? Maybe black can counter. I don't know, if black can counter such a threat, let's say, but maybe bringing his knight to c6. And then after, let's say, cb5 to play ab5. And then if white takes a pawn, to try some crazy tactics, let's say knight d4, hitting a bishop, And threatening knight c2 check. So I will be forced to go back to b3. I don't see other moves. And now something intelligent is needed. Because this bishop somehow needs to be hit. Maybe here is some compensation which was found by Sahaj in his homework. Maybe something connected to some dark squares of some solution which is using a temporary misplacement of Stratescu pieces. This is something which was perhaps spotted by Black, though I do not see it. I see many possibilities for Black, but not a single one which really works. Maybe there is another possibility. Maybe he analyzed knight d4 immediately. Maybe this is what he analyzed. And then after c2, so now I have to take a pawn, because if I don't take a pawn, Black will take a d5 and Black will be good. So then after taking pawn, maybe a check. Bishop d2 is the only move. And then queen takes a6. Maybe something like this. To play like some very funny Volga with the queen on a6. Some kind of strange structure, because the white king now losing internet. I think that I'm not internet. I'm afraid I have lost internet. I will need to go back to this. I would need to go to see how to get internet back.